Also as well, and again, share those different cultural experiences. Okay, so are we ready to start? Well, let's introduce the baby over here. This baby is Deb, and maybe people will be walking around. A lot of times, maybe there'll be a disruption there. Yeah, but you can say hello. You may ask for a kiss, but you can just give them a high five instead. Okay, so high fives for Foda. Okay, are we ready? Should we do the four groups?
Okay, so we're going to go one, twos, threes, and fours. Okay, we're going to start counting around the room. And you remember your number.
Also your identification, if you're deaf, deafblind. And if you have any kind of gender identity that you want to be followed, introduce yourself. And after we introduce ourselves in there, then just pick one experience. Like just a story that is, you know, related to your race. You know, like, oh, you know, that could be your gender, your deafness. And then practice listening to each other. Practice our listening skills. And then that's like provide like a thing, you know, an off. You know, like the deaf people, they don't know about hearing, or the hearing don't know about deaf. So we like do a special experience and provide for each other. You know, like we like we're reading books, you know, and that's how we know about the hearing culture and vice versa. In the history books and everything. You know, one experience about your race or your cultural identity. Okay, ready?
We're not going to say anything. We're not going to jump in or anything unless you have an issue in your group, and then let us know. We do have four interpreters, very cool, that are black, so you'll recognize them. A black with black.
Interpreters in black, like the movie Men in Black.
I think we're good. Okay,
this interpreter, is it okay if I sit
okay,
here?
Okay, so who wants to go first?
Because I'm standing so you can see me better.
Who wants to go first?
Is it okay if I share with you? Okay. Hello, my name is Megan, and I will be running, I'll facilitate the group discussion here now. I'm going to go ahead and be the one to take the floor. And I just want to make sure that you feel safe. And if you don't feel safe, please raise your hand and let me know. And then we can go ahead. And who would like to start? Do you want to go to the left or to the right? Oh, and one more thing. We're going to be using the sign language interpreter. Who's had experience with interpreters here before? Or have you not had any experience? Well, when the interpreter is speaking to a deaf person, you should be making your eye, excuse me, when you're speaking to that person, you should make eye contact with the deaf person, not be looking at the interpreter. Yeah, the deaf person that's signing, okay? And so, and also it's important one person to talk at a time because the interpreter can't be speaking twice for two people. Okay, so who would like to start? Right on left or right?
I'm 16.
You can speak at your normal speed. Just go ahead and I'll keep
up. I've been here 3 months. I wear hearing aids. Mine broke, so I have to go to the shop.
My name's
Maddie.
Is
that
it? That seems fine. Good. Next. My name is Cedric. The last name is Toledo. And this is my sign name. Put a stamp on the chest. And what's cool do you want? Tell us a little bit more about yourself. Who I am? Yeah, what are you? Deaf? Hearing? I'm deaf. And what else can you say? And I'm a junior. I'm a junior in school right now. And I'm 18 years old. And what about your, I consider myself Native American. So that's what I consider Native American. And not a hope. Thank you. Next. My name is, can you support a little so I can do? Yes, my name is Sammy. And this is my sign name. And one thing that happened to me is I saw some things being. Oh, excuse me, Sam, this is my first time coming here. And I have English, Spanish, I do both languages, speak both languages.
French.
And I'm a senior. And so it's my last year and I'll be graduating. And then, when I'll be 21.
related to your culture.
So who's next? Where are you? Okay, I'm Jim Vagel, and I do work at the New Mexico School Board as a school counselor and specialist, and I'm Sam. Hi, my name is Amber Lee, Amber Lee, and I am a senior, and I'm Hispanic and deaf, but we have a hearing aid. And my name is Elise, and my sign name is like this on the chest. And part of my family, I have three different names. I'm one half white, and I'm Mexican, and I'm Asian. So I'm all from my family. I have a man and I'm deaf. But I also consider myself hard of hearing. I do have hearing aids, and I can speak. And at the same time, I can sign. Thank you.
My name is Lucy.
Oh, did you want to add more? No, she's easy. Okay, I wasn't sure if you had more than that. Sorry.
My name is Jordan, and I'm 15. I'm a sophomore. And I have a little extra time. Otherwise,
just your identity. How do you identify yourself? What do you identify with? Thank you.
My name is Chris.
Okay, great, thank you. Okay, so the second part of the question was, I think, didn't she say some type of an experience that you've struggled with or conflict? Do you remember what the second part of this was supposed to be? And I remember she put a lot of information out all at the same time, so maybe we'll have to pull her over and ask Stephanie and try to ask. Forgot the second part of your question. Is this supposed to be an experience related to identity? Cultural identity is something you've struggled with, something that's frustrated you related to cultural identity. So, yeah, when you just recently shared your identity and you said your name, etc. Now something that you've struggled with, something that's frustrated you, made you feel oppressed because of those identities, okay? So who wants to go ahead? You? Are you? He said you're pointing. No, who wants to start? Okay, so I'm going to talk about my deaf
experience.
In the past, I was hearing.
For example,
and so I've had a hard time telling people, but I didn't want to start hearing people. I've been hearing color, but it feels as though they're bullying me. And now I'm deaf. And more reluctant to socialize. But when I feel like when I'm only deaf and I don't have a friend, that's why I look at the kind of things I want to go to the best school where I'm more comfortable. Thank you for sharing that. And so when you were growing up in the mainstream, I see. Okay. So the deaf community does have languages. There's differences in English. I can explain that to more deaf people that don't know much about it. Mainstream is like a regular public school. So some deaf students end up going to public schools on their mainstream. Either they're by themselves and they're the only deaf person in the school, or sometimes there's a deaf group of students within the school at the public school. And or they can end up going to the deaf school too. And in that way they can of course sign with everybody. So just so you understand a little bit more about the different experiences. Thank you. Thank you very much for sharing. Okay. So I also want to
feel like there's a lack of respect.
But I did transfer to a deaf school in New Mexico.
And so they discriminate you because of
the
difference. And also gay and lesbian issues.
And I would up and graduate now and go to college.
Thank you.
And I want to go to California to see CSUN or maybe even to Arizona. But at this point, I'm more successful. It really helped me to Anybody else want to share? Thank you. Okay, so soon we're going to start the second question. So, did anyone want to add anything else about their experience regarding discrimination or oppression and any frustrations you've had in your education? Okay, that's fine. Yes, so we're ready.
Why? Just
one experience that's too much for you.
Sometimes they'll lose the well, they'll take it slowly, they'll go back to the email.
Dinosaurs. I love dinosaurs. okay? You're going to do it on the count of three. One, two, three. I love dinosaurs. Woo! Good job. So the last thing before we close, we're going to do one more question. This is very, very, very important. The Ferguson situation, there's a lot of things happening in Mexico and different things that are really disrupting our community. So I really want to talk about different things like that right now. Sometimes a friend comes up to me and they're like, oh, it's so stupid, these people are getting drunk, and then they ask me about deafness, and a lot of times there are words that are really hurtful. I do have Usher syndrome, and that's a real medical condition that I have. I will become blind later in my life. Some people who don't have that are like, hey, come on, look at me, are you blind or something? And then I feel like that is not okay to say that. Usher's just part of my life, deaf, blind. And so it's a situation that I've had to deal with. And I'm going to share that with you. Okay, just a minute. Okay, so here's what I want you guys to think about. Why do we use those certain words? Like sometimes if someone doesn't pay attention to you, you say, hey, why, you know, are you deaf or something? And that word that we use is autism. And why do we use that term? I want you to discuss that. Sometimes you're afraid to go up to a friend and say, hey, I don't want you to use that term. I mean, even though I'm deaf, they still use words that are insulting. You know, and a lot of times we both value our own culture, but we don't allow the other person to be involved, and they don't realize that those words are hurtful. So now in your groups, maybe talk about how you would approach a friend who uses a word that you don't like. You know, just throw out some of those words, just really basic, but how do we reduce the use of those words in our everyday conversations. Do you need any clarification, or are we good? Just talk about those words that we don't want used in our lives. Okay. So autism is when you are pressuring somebody. It can be hearing to deaf. Again, autism is under. You know, if you're saying, you know, you can't hear me, what are you, deaf, that type of thing. Deaf people actually experience that happening. You know, or if somebody's not paying attention, another deaf to deaf, and they say, what are you, blind? There are some disability terms that are used in specific situations that make you feel frustrated. Suppose somebody calls, they're like, hey, you're handicapped, you're a cripple, or something like that. So why are we using those words in our everyday language? We know there are people out there who live with those words every day. So the question right now, what I want you to talk about is how do we get rid of those words and show that we value our culture? And how do we do that? Just throw out some ideas here. So we have seven over here. So we're thinking maybe we're going to have two join this group. Two of you guys join this group, and then three of you join the group in the back. Actually, let's do 2, 3, 2. So you guys split up and join other groups.
Moving. Yeah.
Yes, only you know, like what's in the word for either.
I know that this is personally, so I'm
So now we're going to go over to, we're going to have the presentation. to share contact information or really meet people, connect people. If this is the first time you've met a deaf person, I hope this is something that continues and that you're able to meet more deaf people throughout your lives. And definitely start asking the questions and sharing those experiences that you're having. So any questions before we wrap up? And Meg, thank you so much over there. Thank you, all of you guys. And all the other staff who supported us. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yep, thanks for earning for watching the baby. Thank you. And thank you to the cameraman also for watching the baby. Thank you. All right.